Water tax. Stop the water tax.
I don't like that right now because
we can't hear you.
Come down in the middle.
Stand in the middle. We can't hear you.
This is unreal.
Shut your mouth down.
Stand in the middle.
Here we go. You got the water tax.
We can't hear you.
How old are you? You got the nuisance tax, right? About what do I think about it? And I think that's horrible right now because I don't know what that means. I don't know if it's going to change moving forward. But I don't see how that would benefit my folks like you that live in Ontario. A water tax, what does that mean? Are we going to have better water reliability?
No.
Clean up in the... I don't know. But it's preliminary. We don't know where that's going to be. So right now, as it stands, I can't support something if it's not going to
benefit
my folks. Right here.
My issue has nothing to do with immigration, I promise.
Okay, hopefully it's about other stuff and not...
Mine has nothing to do with immigration.
I'm a citizen of Ontario, and I do have a question. But first, I'd like to thank you for renaming the freeway for the fallen Pomona police officer who died in the line of duty, Gregory Casillas. Thank you, sir. And I also would like to thank you for explaining how well walls work. But I'd like to ask you how much is enough, because everything you're talking about requires me paying more taxes. Now, I have 22 grandchildren. I have 5 children. My youngest child, the mother is actually from Mexico, so please don't try to banty this racism card to me. I'd like to know how much of a percentage am I supposed to pay my income to pay for all your schemes? Now, you talked about the unfunded pension liabilities. You know, whatever our surplus is, we're not even put a dent in that if we forked over the whole amount to it. It's unsustainable. You talk about this downtown Ontario revitalization. How are you going to revitalize downtown Ontario by building only high-density housing and deleting a lane of traffic for bicycle and walk paths? How many people rode a bike here today? All these people in Ontario, both parents have to work in order to pay their mortgage, and then the only time they have is to take their kids to soccer, baseball, whatever. They don't have time to be riding bikes or walking down a path. It's go, go, go for the society because we are so behind the eight ball paying your taxes. And you voted for every cap and trade and tax bill that came around the corner. And I'm supposed to listen to you, and you don't even know the difference between a boy and a girl. You voted for this gender thing. Do you know what the difference between a man and a woman? There's two genders. There's no such thing as non-binary. God made man, God made woman. He did not make a non-binary.
That's
on top of it, you say, oh, I just came from taking care of my senior parents, but yet you voted for two bills to kill seniors. What am I supposed to believe anything you say, or should I address my questions to your staff? Are you merely a headpiece, a puppet, or can you think for yourself? And the bullet, magazine ban. First, you vote for the magazine ban, high-capacity magazine ban. Then you vote for the bullet button. Do you know what a bullet button is? And why would you have a bullet button ban when you already banned high-capacity magazines? What's the sense of that? You just want to disarm us. In fact, you voted against officers carrying firearms on school campuses. Now, if there was armed security on a campus, these shootings wouldn't be happening because all these shootings happen in gun-free zones. So I believe you want to disarm us so you can usher in your scheme of putting us out into Texas or waiting for us to die and then inviting all your illegal alien friends over here. You know, if those people don't have enough courtesy to come here legally, why are we giving them earned income tax credit? Why are we paying for their health insurance? It's outrageous and it's uncalled for. And I bet you $5 you locked your house before you came over here. Do you have a wall around your house, sir? Go ahead and answer any one of those questions if you can.
Well, thanks for sharing your concerns.
Or maybe your staff could do it.
Thank you for sharing your concerns and things. Obviously, you know the way I voted on things.
Yeah,
unfortunately,
you're correct.
I'm not going to probably come to grips on everything.
We're
going to
have
differences
of opinion. You're not doing
anything
to help me or my 22 grandchildren.
And
except trying to run us out of town.
Thank you for coming and sharing your concerns. I gave you this the time to speak about your issues and concerns, and I want to thank you for bringing that to our attention, the community's attention.
So what are you going to do about it?
We can those things, and like I said, your mind's pretty much made up.
What are you
going to
do about it?
There's
answer really one of the questions, just one of
that,
them.
I'm just here to provide resources for my community. We can talk about what's happening in the
past. I'm your community. My 22 children are your community, not illegal aliens.
Yeah, we want everybody to be safe and
taken
care of.
They're foreign nationals. We shouldn't be giving them a red shirt.
You don't need to speak. But with that said, thank you for bringing that to
answer
our attention.
Answer one question.
All right. Just my issue does not touch immigration.
Not one question, Kenny.
I don't see why it should be silenced, but...
Outrageous.